The Bible says, and behold, there was a woman, no name. There was a woman, no name. There was a woman. Here also is a woman this morning. Am I talking to somebody in the house of God? It says, there was a woman. Her problem has consumed her name. And you know the worst thing that can ever happen to any woman is for people to describe you by your circumstance than by your name. The worst thing that can happen to a woman is for people to look at you and forget the fact that Rahab is your name. Instead of them calling you Rahab, must they add a suffix to it? Why must they go on beyond Rahab and say Rahab? In case you are confused about which one we're talking about, Rahab the harlot, meaning the harlot is more popular than her name. The reason, the major challenge women are having today is their inability to stand beside their men as helper. There are several things keeping women today from standing beside their men as helpers. Number one of the major reasons today why most women can't stand up to help their husbands, one of the major reasons why they can't stand beside their husband, stand up, help me. The reason she can't stand up is because of the memory of her own family background. I deal with that every day. Most women are too battered by the kind of family they come from, such that they find it difficult to be of help to any other man. Woman of God, deal with the family background you come from. Number two, there are women who can stand beside their husbands to help them. The enemy has lowered them, bent them low, using memories of their previous relationships. You had a broken relationship. You had a bad marriage in the past and all of that. And so because of that today, you are seeing the world through the lenses of your past. I'm sure you know that if you wear photochromic glass that is blue, I'm sure that when you look at the world, what would be the color of the world? Does that mean the world is blue? See, if your lenses are already shaded by the relationships you've had, you will not see men as they truly are. And by the way, the number of men you have met in your lifetime, they are too small for you to use a sample size to determine how all men behave. The glory of an African man is in the well-being of his wife. So for all of you, our women, we thank God you are trying to slim down. But please, don't slim down to the point where we're not confused. Are you sick? Please remain plenty small. Are you getting what I'm saying now? Some of you can't stand in the presence of God because of self-image. My nose is too big. My mouth is too big. One of the most liberating stories in this church that I love so very much was that of Mrs. Alunge, who initially, she was worried about her lips. And she thought her lips was a minus. The woman that took praise worship with attitude. The woman that led that worship with attitude. That's the woman that thought she had a disadvantage with her lips. Only for her to start realizing that people like Steve Harvey, that his mouth has been insured. Millions. That his mouth is his brand. And the woman now began to accentuate what God has blessed her with. Are you tall? Accept it as a gift. Are you brief and locomoted like some of us? Accept it. It gives you ability to move fast. If you are black, stop bleaching. Black is beautiful. Where are you bleaching to? Let me warn you, no matter how you bleach, you are still a black woman. If you as a woman can have all the five things that I've mentioned. Number one, that you are standing daily before your God. Number two, that you are standing by your man as a helper. Number three, that you are standing behind your children as a mother. Number four, that you are standing and walking in your calling. Number five, that you are standing and you are blessing your community and your generation. It is what makes you to be a maximized woman.